first German airship in its hangar. I was astounded by its immensity until I saw my own name printed on its side. At that moment, an entirely new feeling unveiled within me. It was an emotion which frequented me in childhood, a blend of revulsion and satisfaction that had followed the execution of a cruel jest on a friend or a stranger, a pin in one's foot, a tumble down a stairwell. What would others think, I thought to myself, at the sight of a foreign airship bearing the name of the American president, dropping explosives upon cities of unarmed civilians. I wish to say that revulsion was my sole reaction to this invention, yet I cannot deny that I was proud of this magnificent vehicle. It was perhaps the greatest war machine ever developed by mankind, made possible by yours truly. By nightfall, shame outweighed pride, and I requested the immediate removal of my name from the airship and all its future successors. Although the Germans complied, they continued to refer to their airships as Rockefellers. I knew that removing my name would not obscure the facts for very long. It was inevitable that the American public would one day become aware of my secret dealings in Germany. It had always been my intention to reinvigorate the American economy. Once I had been debriefed of the situation in the Grand Canyon, the overpopulation of crowns, I realized that I was also hearing the beginnings of a solution to the impending economic collapse. That solution being slavery. I can imagine your reluctance to read on, and I entirely understand. Rest assured, I believe that all citizens should be unconditionally promised the very freedoms that our country established at its founding. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. However, crowns are not men or women. Nor are they animals. They are merely the decayed shells of ignoble criminals. They do not qualify for the same freedoms exercised by ordinary civilians. Once they were conditioned and bound together, the crowns became the perfect workforce. They did not rebel, for they could not speak. They could not leave. They were chained, and best of all, the crowns were incapable of forming unions. Germany was the first nation to inquire about the crowns and their potential applications in warfare. I never mentioned the vast quantities of geyser glass we owned, since I knew that it could provide them with many more crowns at low cost. Instead, after signing several agreements and receiving a tremendous German sum, I provided them with over 100 crowns, along with my best advisors and the brightest engineers. Our time with the Germans gave rise to the greatest military vehicles in history, the Rockefellers. Germany's growing demand for men and crowns to construct more Rockefellers revitalized the American economy. Very few nations offered to hire as many of our men and women, and none would have paid as graciously as Germans did. It was, by all accounts, the greatest and most sustainable partnership of recent times. I could not have foreseen the destruction those airships would eventually inflict to the very nation that provided them. I thought that their creation would unite Germany and America. I could not have predicted that by 1918, Rockefeller bombing raids would have killed thousands of American and European soldiers. My terms were over before I could take action against the Germans. It was the administration after my own which was tasked with the seemingly impossible mission of destroying the Rockefellers while preserving the reputation of the former president. Although they knew of my dealings in Germany and had every opportunity to expose me, they chose not to, for in their eyes, no good could come of it. However, I knew it was only a matter of time before I would become the laughingstock of my country. As the war drew to a close, I often found myself in a daze, envisioning my assassination on the streets of New York, or, more likely, on the steps of my very own center. However, it would be years before my visions would acquire any plausibility. President Hughes did a fine job of eliminating every Rockefeller while concealing my involvement. It is a miracle that only now the news of my involvement in the Great War has become widely known. Thankfully, information on the crowns has continued to stay hidden from the public spotlight. I would much rather have the public believe that Germans were the only persons inside when the airships were shot down and crashed in flames. With the tragedy at the center, and now the airship scandal, known by many as the Rockefeller Revelation, I believe that my failures have finally caught up to me. There are men outside the center who had once been my supporters. Now, they want me executed. The policemen have kept the crowds at bay, though I believe that my assassination is, like the revelation, inevitable. To be elected the president of a country is the greatest honor a people can bestow. But at the moment, I do wish to be the famous oil tycoon that young Virginia Arnoldson believed I was. Forgive me,